Hi, hold on. I am coming.
Hi there. Sorry, a bit of a one-woman show here. Hi, I'm Kendall Hunter. I've had my computer set up here with a teleprompter running and me reading stuff, and it just hasn't been working, so I've shut the computer down and I thought I would just try to sit here and talk to you a bit about Culture Doc. The way I do, just, you know, when I talk to people and I share with them what I'm doing. A lot of the time I'm working on my own. I do have a fantastic tech team at AppLab behind me. But the whole business development, I've been pushing ahead a lot on my own. And so, you know, I make those baby steps forward, sometimes huge steps backward, and sometimes giant steps forward. And it gets kind of, when I'm on my own, I lose the perspective of it a bit. And then when I start to talk about it to people, that's when I feel the energy getting going, and I get so excited because this is actually something that could be really, really big and change a lot of people's lives. And I couldn't be more proud than to be the person behind this. I feel like so many aspects of my life over the last 30, 35 years have actually come together and brought me to this point. And it's everything I believe in, actually. It includes culture, it includes travel, it includes development, sustainable development, helping marginalized people. And I'm really proud of it. So what we're building is a social marketplace for ethical shopping. So if you think like Etsy, but for ethical shopping. And it will involve the fair trade economy, as well as traditional artisans in other countries that aren't necessarily part of the global south, and who are, you know, working with traditional techniques that are, you know, under threat of being lost and forgotten. But as far as the fair trade economy goes, I mean, this, what we've done, that is, the fair trade system is something that is working already. With supply and demand, it's effective. And what we've done, though, is we've taken fair trade and we've placed it on a centralized platform, a tech platform, and bolstered it. So what we're seeing, or what the potential is here, is for marginalized artisans to open their own stores and to set their own prices. And then for consumers to actually be buying for a bit less, potentially, because we've removed the middleman that is now present in fair trade, and, you know, retail stores are taking profits. And I mean, a social marketplace is the ideal platform for fair trade, and that's what we're creating. And then, you know, to use this word again, we're bolstering it even more with a loyalty program to keep people coming back time and again and earning rewards and cashing them in and to keep on buying on the platform. But when I talk to people who are potential partners and partners I've made, like the World Fair Trade Organization, big people who are involved in fair trade, and they're all really excited about this. They see the potential. They recognize it. You know, they're all for it. And what they're saying, though, to me is what's making this really unique, Kendall? You know, like, what stands out? And I tell them that we're leveraging the travel industry. And travelers are those who are vibing with, you know, international products and authentic, you know, handmade items that they're looking for when they're shopping. They might not want to pack them when they're coming home. They might not have found them when they're traveling. They might want to continue that international shopping experience when they get home. And they can do that on Culture Doc. And, you know, the super exciting thing here is, you know, I've been in talks with Air Canada, and they are saying that they are interested in having it as a sponsored app on in-flight entertainment. So we'd have that 1 million plus audience, you know, of people flying on Air Canada, and potentially the whole Star Alliance of, you know, the whole fleet of Star Alliance aircraft from countries all over, having it in flight. And so there's a captive audience, you know, on board and shopping for international items, products. And so that's what makes us stand out. I mean, apart from it being a social marketplace and the perfect model for fair trade, we're going to have traction with the travel industry, and we're going to change a lot of people's lives. Everything about this is just, you know, winning for everybody, the consumer, people who are making the products, and I just can't wait to get it out there. I've been at this for a long time. It's been four and a half years, and I've persisted, and I've pivoted, and I just need to power this up now with some capital so we can empower people around the world, and I really hope that I get to see you and make this happen. Thank you.